You know the vibes. We got Niecy on the track.
Top of the week, and I want to talk about a little bit of the conversation that we were having on the live stream. We were talking about some aggressive street riding, some how-tos, this and that. But remember, all of your riding starts here at the house in your garage. So before you jump on your bike and go anywhere out in the world, you want to make sure while you're at the house, you go ahead and check your maintenance on your motorcycle, and that motorcycle is ready for you to do any kind of ride for the day. The main focus is going to be about braking. So I got to run to an auto store and get some fluids and some stuff for a car that I got to work on today. While we do that, I've got cameras set up to show you specifically braking. Braking is the biggest key of going fast. You have to slow down, right? No matter how fast your motorcycle is, it's always got to come to a halt. We'll talk about braking techniques. Combo braking, using the front and the rear at the same time. Solo with just the front or just the rear. Or modulating, depending on how much, you know, the situation calls for front pressure to rear pressure. I'm gonna voice over it so that everything will come across really clear and smoothly. Let's get on the way.
No matter how fast I'm riding, no matter what type of riding I'm doing, I'm always ready to pop out two fingers on the brakes. So even if I'm jamming and coming around cars, brakes are at the ready. I'm here about to get off the freeway, so I throw a downshift, not quite decelerating yet, but once I apply these brakes, then that's when the slowdown actually happens. And when that slowdown happens, I add back brake. So majority of the downshifting and slowing down is by brake, and then I release the front brake, and the rear brake just does the rest. This is totally fine when you're just coming up to the stop on the street or just regularly, casually. So then right here, like I said, I'm always covering the brake. There's people on the sidewalk with a potential I can come by a parking lot that some idiot will exit out on. You know, just always check up with the hand and the foot. That's just always law for me. Because obviously I ride pretty quickly on the street. And riding quickly on the street, everybody always asks, like, aren't you scared? Aren't you this? Aren't you that? Like, nah, not really, you know, because you kind of generally know what to expect as I look over and see all of those students right there in the lot doing the MSF motorcycle course. Hella funny. Like, I never took it, but I mean, I learned so much just riding in the street. Once you get confident about getting a bike around and maneuvering through towns, I say just ride, and the more you ride, the more experience you get, the more safety conscious you are, the better of a rider you do become. So as I'm jamming down now in my local area with this terrible road, you have to notice the roads that you're on too, cracks, dust, debris, things like that. All of those things are gonna deal with the lack of adhesion, and you gotta be safe, you gotta be careful and think about that. I love screwing around with this. Let me show you what a heavy rear brake application looks like. That's a whole lot of sliding going on, one of my favorite things to do, but let's break that down.
Typically, you can use the brakes in any style that you want. Obviously, it's up to your comfort level. More of a rear breaker than a front breaker? Cool. Brake more with the rear, but add your assist from the front. More of a front than a rear? Vice versa. I showed you a few different braking situations. The most extreme one was obviously the skid, as that looked like it was all rear brake. It was front brake controlling that as well. So yes, we applied heavy rear brake to start the slide, but the slide would just go out of control if it wasn't for the front brake. So as you start to slide the bike gets sideways, you lightly apply front brake. And as you lightly apply front brake, it's literally getting the bike sideways and then tucking the front so that the front stays as your anchor. That's now your pivot, that it's still driving around, but it's slowing down. See, if the bike is just doing this on its own and your front is just carelessly going, you get sideways and wash and goes low side. So you can also high side too if you release the brakes and the bike goes back in line. It kicks you up. Now, that was at low speed, but you can do the exact same thing at a higher speed. These are Q3s, right? These Q3s are a little bit more grippy than, let's say, rocking some of those or rocking some of those. The Q4s, I can almost not skid them like that. I have to give a gratuitous amount of back break. But these Q3s allow a little bit of slip. So what we were able to do is just show it at a low speed. You can also do the same thing at high speed. When motorcyclists are backing their bikes in, and we call that backing the bike in. When you're backing the bike into a corner, you're either doing one of two things. Using the back torque from the engine on deceleration of the engine RPM. So say you're in third gear and you're going into a corner, but you're diving into this corner hardcore and you downshift from third to second, and that back torque of the engine RPM climbing before it matches the ground pace and starts to decel, it makes the rear tire skid. So you could either do that rolling in, or you could use a lot of rear brake that drops the engine RPM, obviously, and it makes the rear tire not come to a stop like we did on the low speed, because that's really the only way that you're going to do that at low speed. But it brings the wheel rotation down slower than you're traveling, which makes the bike skid. I'm explaining those two things because all of those instances uses a combination of a little bit of front brake. Your braking has to be very on point. You need to know how you're vibing with that. You can be doing a little bit or a lot of bit of braking. It's just up to how your brakes are set up, how good they are, and how responsive they are. Knowing the Brembo Master, I know how this operates. I have the same master on all of my Yamahas. This one, with a stock lever being bigger, bulkier, and longer, I can use two fingers and just give it just a little bit of braking. If I was to use this bike with the shorter lever, it takes a little bit more of a pull to get the same effort that that lever gives. But because I'm super comfortable with how these levers work, it would be the same thing essentially. So anyway, combo braking is always the best coming to a straight stop. Going to a straight stop with just the front brake takes a little bit longer, right? You use just the front, your front suspension compresses, the rear raises up because it's still at motion. So your bike is doing this to a stop. You're not managing this weight back here. You're only managing the front to slow the bike down. So that's why it takes longer just braking with your front. If you just brake with your rear, it takes longer because you only have one teeny tiny little diameter disc back there and one caliper. So these by themselves work fine depending on how you're riding, but when you add them both together, front brake and back brake, the bike settles down and just zzz, comes to a quicker stop. Maybe I'll go out on this one and show you like a hard acceleration and then just using both brakes to come to a halt. We'll mark it and then we'll start the same place, do a quick acceleration, use just the rears to come to a halt, mark that, and just the fronts to come to a halt and mark that. And what would a video with me riding a motorcycle be without me putting that first wheel in the air, getting that first one out? Bam! And look at that back brake. You can control the rate of the wheel. Not only your wrist, but a combination of wrist and back brake. So you always gotta recognize that and control. And look at this 630. Like nothing. I mean, that's what a man moves right there. Always put the front on sixes, but boy. Now, check this out. As I exit the freeway, you see that unison in front and back brake? As I'm rolling through the corner, I'm at the ready with the front brake. When I get ready to use the brake, to firmly apply the brake, and then use the back, then roll off both. It's just a unison that you have to have. Well, this is tragic. They fucked the spot up. Now, it's only for motorcycles. Interesting. I still see a playground here, but this sucks. I was gonna present something here. Damn, that's weak. Well, this throws a monkey wrench in the viewpoint that I wanted to get. Damn, I wanted to show like, oh man, this kind of screws it up. I wanted to come off of this corner here, digging hard, get into the brakes and come in here and change direction. Kind of like to show you could brake on deep angle.
but we'll have to find another way to do that on another day. Okay, I'm gonna start here at this railroad switch. I'm just gonna accelerate first gear all the way to the limiter. Once we get the stop sign, then slow it on down. All right, this is gonna be front brakes. This is gonna be just rear brakes.
So before you get out there really wild and find a place to practice that you can get real good and comfortable with slowing that bike down in any position. No panic braking. Nothing should catch you off guard. Nothing should make you be startled. Always be very comfortable with these brakes. So I want you to practice that and get real aggressive with it. And then everybody have a good, safe time. And with this experience game, I'm going to give y'all two. And remember, braking